terms of the main responsibilities in the portfolio, it's on the screen there. It's about promoting growth through the key growth sectors, maximising investment by working with developers and investors, focusing on the strategic sites and infrastructure within the city region, supporting economic growth through the single investment fund we've just been talking about, and then looking at an industrial strategy for the city region, and then finally developing a world-class cultural offer. And the thing I think, Steve, that you just touched on, which I think is important to note, is how there's an overlap with my portfolio, with almost every other portfolio. You know, you can't talk about infrastructure without talking about transport. You can't talk about the key economic sectors without talking about skills. So I think that's an important point to make. So if I just briefly look at each of the priorities. Key growth sectors. We're doing a review at the moment of what those key growth sectors should be. Within the existing growth plan, we've got seven sectors, which feels probably quite long and quite broad. So we're looking at, can we be a bit more kind of focused on what the absolutely critical ones are. And then within them, within those key growth sectors, asking the questions about what are the key priorities for those businesses, those companies, and obviously that's where we've just had a debate about skills and training, but you know, there'll be other things as well. So we need to get under the skin of some of those issues. And then look at how we can kind of, what can the, not just the CA, but us working collectively as a city region, all the agencies we've been talking about today, what interventions can we make to make a difference to help those key sectors thrive, flourish and go forward. And then thirdly, again, about CA, about bringing funding streams together. So it's not just about the SIF, it's about how we can add value by bringing all the multiplicity of funding that we now have to at our disposal, local growth funding and so on. How can we bring all that together in one pot for the benefit of the city region? And that takes me on to investment. So investment is obviously critical, because without investment we can't do very much. So we need a coherent investment strategy for the city region, with a delivery plan with measurable kind of outcomes. We need to be clear what our unique selling proposition is in the city region, what will be most competitive, how can we add value to attract that investment to the Liverpool city region and not go elsewhere. Thirdly, what resources and what structures do we need to deliver to attract that investment? And I think that's about working smarter. It's about making sure that we've got one united offer, bringing all the key agencies together. So rather than companies having to go to 10, 11, 12 separate places, they go to one place and get good, high-quality service. I call that a one-stop-shop model. We do need to fully engage with all the key players. I've listed a few of them there, but you know, business organisations, particularly Frank McKenna's organisation, is a key one we need to engage with. And and again, this overlaps with Asif and his portfolio around business. And then finally, I just mentioned it, maximise it. In the interim, you can't stand still. We need to maximise opportunities for investment while we're putting together our strategic strategy. Sites and infrastructure. I think the key immediate challenge is to make sure we spend the SIF money and we spend it wisely. I've listed a few on the slide of the key strategic sites and schemes which have received SIF funding or currently being appraised. The SIF money was a key achievement, I think, from the devolution deal. We need to make sure we spend it wisely, and as I say, bring it together with the other multiplicity of funding opportunities that are now available to us. In terms of future actions, we clearly need to make sure that we maximise the opportunities in our two enterprise zones, Mersey Waters and Daresbury. We need to be looking now, and we are, at the options for look at the what are the next big infrastructure opportunities in the Liverpool City region. Steve, we talked about tidal barrages and fibre loops and the like, and we really do need to, as I know we are, make significant progress with them now. And then, as I said earlier, we need to develop a single strategic funding model to bring all of these funding pots together in one place. Single investment fund, we talked about that. I won't really kind of go over what we talked about. We've got 48 projects which have been approved at the strategic outline case, all of which are in different parts of the appraisal process. Some have full business cases agreed and going forward, other are still outline business cases. But the key thing is we need to make sure that we spend the money and it's spent wisely. But we're also now looking at future SIF rounds, and we had a discussion earlier on, I think it is the way forward, about having a more strategic themed approach, and more commissioning rather than an open call that really focuses on the key things that we want to see achieved within the city region. And then finally, the Liverpool City Region Industrial Strategy. Clearly, the government early this year launched their National Industrial Strategy. We need to play into that to make sure that we get the best opportunities for the city region. We need to build on the science and innovation audit, which is a really good piece of work that was done recently. And we need to really focus on the kind of what we call the place-based approach. So we focus on our strengths, our opportunities, and what is our kind of USP going forward. So those are the main ideas for future work within the economic development portfolio. And I want to talk very briefly about culture, because I haven't really got much time, but this is the other part of my portfolio. Clearly, an area where we've got significant opportunities in terms of the kind of importance of culture to the city region, this to economy particularly. We need to be, I think, very adept at bidding for regional and national funding opportunities that are coming down the line, and we're looking at a number of them at the moment. Relationships with our key partners is obviously important. We need to have a really high quality events program that brings, you know, significant numbers of visitors to the city region economy, and we're working on that at the moment. And we need to really focus on our creative industries and cultural sector. It is a really important economic sector, often underestimated and undervalued, but I think there are huge opportunities for growth around those industries. And I talk about film, digital technology industries. And that's, again, where it crosses over with the skills portfolio, because there are opportunities there on skills and apprenticeships. But most particularly engaging our communities in the cultural agenda. I think there are great opportunities for having showcasing the best of each of the borough's cultural offers over the next few years. So what are we doing at the moment? I've been working quite closely, as other colleagues, with Phil Redmond, who's doing a big piece of work around a cultural partnership report, which is due out in the summer of next year, which is a 30-year plan for culture within the city region. We obviously need to join up with the work that Phil's doing. I mentioned the importance of an events programme, and I've listed a few there for next year, which I think are really exciting. We have got opportunities around applying for funding and being part of larger national initiatives. So there's the Great Exhibition of the North next year being held in Newcastle Gateshead, which showcases the best of art and design and innovation. We need to be showcasing the best of what we can offer in the city region. There's a pot of money called the Northern Cultural Regeneration Fund. It's only 15 million, but it's about building a regional legacy from that great exhibition for the North. We need to be setting it to the plate and putting forward bids to take advantage of that funding. And then finally, we're all going behind, obviously, the bid for the Channel 4 headquarters to be located to Liverpool. Okay, so finally, Steve, in terms of future want to develop this simple strategic funding model to deliver the key priorities I've mentioned. We want to look at developing a coherent and strategic investment international strategy and more importantly delivery plan, and look at the priorities for increasing growth and productivity in our key growth sectors. And then finally, culture.